Hello, welcome to the beginning, the start. Chapter 1, Baby's First Steps. 20 games with humans, game number 1. I am Durrun. We do dwarves. Yay! Everyone's favorite, dwarves. I actually like dwarves, so it's a little facetious on my part to say such a thing, but... Busted movement troll slayer. Should probably fire him. Did he win? He did win. Okay. I guess that's why he didn't just... I don't know. But anyway, 20 games with... basically, what we do is we just show 20 games with a race. And you can kind of see how it shapes up. To take a team and just run it a little bit deep. 20 games is deep enough. See a team develop. We don't re-roll. Team gets wrecked, we roll on. Show you what happens in that scenario as well. There's a couple that got wrecked. I think the High Elf series I did didn't do very well. I'm not High Elf. Well, actually, none of my elves did very well. Wood Elves did terrible. The one that was good was right when they brought Champ Ladder in. And I had to restart it because I got... I was doing it on the open ladder before. And I got... 5 concedes in 7 games, so that's not really a good representation. You gotta play games to see what it's like, so. Started over on Champ, got destroyed. But I'm not an elf coach, so this should be interesting, because these guys are a little everything. Average blokes. I saw the C1 at the, or CI at the start there, and I thought, oh god, is it that crazy guy with the lizard team who's on top? No. Some other guy who plays in that league, obviously. Not sure what the debate was over. You don't want to spend your bank on a babe with dwarves. Dwarves have thick skull. They kind of already have a babe built in, so. You only get a babe with dwarves if your inducement money has 50k left over, really. You go ahead and lick yourself, kitty. Nobody's going to stop you. Big yawn. Have a nap. You do you. Take a nice long nap, actually. So you're not bugging me for supper. Many hours early, as usual. Our first arena stadium, we're playing at home. Yeah, look at those beautiful uniforms I bought. I spent 20 scions. Get the beautiful yellow and blue. Aren't they pretty? Wow. Pretty cool. Pretty spiffy. We stand out. I almost got the black and white checkerboard ones, but they were 40 scions. So this may be one of the few times I play humans, so. Buy jerseys for teams. I spend more money on jerseys for teams I play a lot more often. But for now, ooh, interesting. I think I'm gonna receive because I don't know what I'm doing. Well, I shouldn't say I don't know what I'm doing. I know how to play Blood Bowl, but don't have a ton of experience with humans. I probably have more experience with them in the campaign than fucking actually playing games. He is a loner, but they're probably the best loners out there, aren't they? Look, it's a Longbeard loner. Still armor 9, still comes a block, tackle, thick skull. Yeah, see, this is where I suffer. I like to hit things, right? This is a terrible matchup to hit shit. I mean, there's 3 armor 8s, but they're always going to be hidden. Do have 1 mighty blow, but of course it's the ogre who doesn't have block. So I guess I have to try and finesse this somehow. It's not my strength. I'm not gonna lie. I'm not gonna deny. So tighten these guys up a touch. Obviously, I want to hit that Troll Slayer since he left him out there. Set up properly for once. Proper, and by that I mean actually get the fucking hits in that I want. You stay back a little bit. No. Okay, don't stay back a little bit. We'll put you here. So what do I want to level on game one? Well, I guess Blitzer levels would be good. For early. Okay, I'm kind of tipping my hand a little bit there, but I don't think it's any secret I should go after the Troll Slayer, so. High kick, beautiful. I probably should let a catcher do it. Yeah. Gotta get that SPP though. And pushes. Nice. Right where we left. Well, I shouldn't say right where we left off from last night. Last night I had skulls and pushes, so. Let's wait for the rest of the turn and see if it levels out. Oh, there's a hit. Okay. Ooh, random armor break. Kinda hope those are, oh, thick skull doing work already. Damn. Feels terrible. Holy shit, can I get the runner? I can, but that's super greedy. I don't think I should be super greedy this early. Yeah, I don't think I can get surfed. Not if I knock him down. No, because he has to blitz with him, so. Nice! I wanted to get in on the run. I didn't realize I didn't have that much movement. Play a team with more movement and misjudge it. Awesome. Well, I definitely don't want to touch him. I don't want to be friends with him. I guess I leave that. Oh shit! GFI. Not punished. Alright. That'll do. Alright, so we pull you here. I'm gonna throw the ogre block first. I think the odds are better than the pickup. We'll get him in there too. Go get some. Alright. That being said, I'm still gonna try pass. Let's farm that SPP, boys. Back in behind there. Boom. All right, pretty good first turn, actually. Got a random armor 9 break, armor 8. Was a little more planned for, but still kind of lucky, though, with no mighty blow. Of course, the ogre's got he's playing with 3 dwarves, so that's kind of cool. And he actually can't get the assist. It's going to be a one die if he wants to take it. He will take it, let's be real. He's got block. He will throw that block, but question is when? I would assume after the blitz, wherever that's going to be. That's a terrible blitz. Gotta go for the low-hanging fruit early on. That's always my motto. It's like, yeah, it would be great to remove a piece with a block, but it's not like you have any advantage to remove it. You don't have any mighty blow. Guess that's not gonna stop him. He's thinking ogre. Yeah, punished. Alright, but he lost the reroll, so he did get punished. He is gonna get a 2 die on the ogre, though. Gonna start basing shit. Pretty standard dwarf stuff. Now, ideally, at the end of my turn, I think I want to run this guy out. I'll try to dodge. But obviously, that's at the end of my turn. The ogre's not going to blitz. Hopefully, he stands up. Okay. That's what I want, but I can only get the two die on you. Choose the thrower. Oh, unless this gives me two die. Yeah, it does. Alright, hit the runner. I can hit him again, I guess. Nice. Saw those pals from a mile away. Got blocked. Do I want to throw this block? I don't think I do. Don't base. Get it in your head. Don't base. He's going to throw one dies all day long. It's just going to tilt you. He can't really run around, right? I guess if he blitz down, then he can move this guy. So we'll double up on you. Plant you over here. Still have my blitz, right? I do. Okay. Oh, here's my blitz. Push him in front of the ogre. Or I still have all three. Okay. I'm not crazy about re-rolling there. But. Jump over here. Hopefully I still can. Yes, I can. I can still try the dodge. Not gonna follow. Gotta tell myself, don't give up blocks, don't give up blocks. Yeah, he can't get around. So we're gonna turn this guy into a scoring threat. Actually, we're going to turn this guy into a threatening threat against the other runner. Because if his runners go out, of course this game gets a lot easier. But with no bench, I guess any two dwarves out makes this game a lot easier, doesn't it? Dwarves are probably the worst when they go down in numbers. Because they're so slow. I guess undead could be too, if you're not running enough ghouls. Or you're on defense and your ghouls are on the bench and you've got nothing but zombies, whites, and mummies. Go down numbers, that can be bad too. But. Still 8 armor. See, catcher's 8 armor. Wow, it just blows my mind. I always forget that too. 8 movement and 8 armor. 88. 88. Star Wars. Yep. What was that? Return of the Jedi? Jabba the Hutt? He was a torture droid. Little useless fact for you. He was the long, skinny, white one. Alright. Fine. We're gonna get broken. We're only armor 8. It's gonna happen. Here come the one dice. I've got a sneaky feeling he'll just instantly reroll any like skull on a one die. So I'm kind of hoping to see a few more. Excuse me. Exactly what I didn't want to happen is happening. I'm based, like, everywhere. So standing him up is only going to give me a one die. But I don't really have anything else to do with him. So. I don't trust the ogre. I don't trust the ogre as far as I can throw him. Let's run away. Oh, it's one. Oh, it's 1-9. Oh my god, I heard a big ding ding. I don't know why I thought it was the fire alarm. That's just everybody. You guys would hear the fire alarm too. It's disgustingly loud. All right, but if I go here, I get a 3 die on this guy. I don't think this makes my life any easier, but. Oh no, I don't get a 3 die on him. What was I thinking? What was I thinking? Not sure what I was thinking. I kind of just turned. Now the ogre has to do something. That's never a good sign. Good luck, Mr. Ogre. Alright, good stuff. Alright, so he's tying up a couple guys. Got my 1 die on the runner. Question is, do I try and dodge him first? I am a little exposed. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. It's only 1 GFI to hit me. For 2. Oh, 2 strength. Yeah, see, I gotta get that in my head. They only have 2 strength. Of course, if I move this guy, then the Troll Slayer. Alright, we're trying it. We're gonna be. Alright. It's a push, but we'll take it. Now we'll try the dodge. Got away. You try more dodges? What's. Oh, this guy. Oh, shit. Yeah, I guess. Yeah, but what's. What. Oh, shit. Alright, I gotta push him in the way at least. I gotta push you in the way at least. Oh, for fuck's sakes. 1 of 36. Yay. Proper punishment. Yep.
No, it's not supper time. You calm down. You're way early, kitty. You're way early. Not even 4 o'clock.
Go take a nap. Any advice on how to play humans would be greatly appreciated. As I'm flying with limited knowledge here. I'm thinking if I can get it back to the thrower and heave it to that blitzer. I think I've burned enough turns that I can stop him. Oh, I just fucked. Oh, it's the loner though. Dub skulls would be pretty cool. Dub pushes are good too though. Oh, fuck you. Makes the loner roll. He didn't follow, though. That's a bad decision, dude. See, you're gonna step there anyway. Wanna follow and put tackle on him. I know that much. I know dwarves, kitty. Yeah, I know dwarves. You wouldn't know from my UK BBL team. The game I punted this week. But somehow I managed to find a way to lose a game when I was up 3 players after turn 9 was over. Dwarves are tough, though. He's burning his rerolls, though. I guess, yeah. All the more reason to score quickly, I guess. If I can somehow get away. Another push. That's good. Alright. He's got enough sense to keep his runners free. Or that runner free. The other one dove right back in, didn't it? Yeah. I guess I get all the skulls on the 1 dies this game. My lot in life. Roll skulls. Oh, my throw is... Oh, there we go. My throw is on the ground, so I guess, I guess I can't get it to him and biff it this turn, can I? No, you're the two die, right? Alright. You can eat a bolt down, though. How do I help these two losers, though? I don't know if I can. I have to do this first. I need assistantship. Alright. Nice hits would be good too, yes. More stuns. Everybody's stunning. It's a stunning game of Blood Bowl. Yes, it is, King. Can't tell me otherwise. Is he free? Oh, he's loose. Okay. He's got tackle, so you're the one that I want. I guess I put you up. I don't think you helped me any, but no, still one die. Still my only hope. Cause yeah, I'd like to dodge him maybe. I regret nothing. What did I? Come on, game. Thank you. Holy fuck. You'd think I was asking it to move the sun and the stars for me or something. Could just get a double die on him and stand still, but that doesn't get me... I don't think that gets me anywhere. Mark the runner or take... No, I got out of rerolls. Let's mark the runner. Alright, can't dodge you now. Stand up. You run now. The runner could... Oh, shit. I don't have this runner covered. And he can go quite a ways. If this worked, he would kind of cut him off a little bit. I gotta run this way, though. Potato into the left! To the left, kitty. To the left. Yeah, see, now he has to... 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. It's a GFI to hit me, anyway. If this fails, one, two, three, four, five, six, seven. It's two GFIs for a two die. Yeah, I think I just have to accept the dwarven one die bonanza that will be this turn. Well, at least it's a blitz, though, which means the ball carrier is not getting blitzed. So that's something. It is kitty. Don't tell me it's not. And he set up a block with the fucking... Yeah, just move over, dude. Don't be cute. That's the same as the side. I just go to the left. I guess it could go out of bounds if I go left, though. Yeah. So there's some merit to that play, I guess. Hoping I get the last reroll. I do not. I'm surprised there's no removals yet, to be honest. Oh, had to open my mouth. Oh, dodge, right, yeah, he doesn't have tackle. That's why I did what I did when I did what I did. Yeah, you got nothing. You can throw that one die if you like, but it's blocking the block. There it is. Oh? Oh, it's his last reroll. I guess he's not going to auto reroll it, is he? Look at that punishment. Look at it. How good is that? Again, I have no rerolls. So what's the ideal play here? None of this is two dice? Thought I'd have a two die. I thought wrong, apparently. Oh, you're loose, though. Okay. So we gotta get you moving. I think the blitz is the play, though. I could get another free blitzer, though. I guess I should try that first. You start the place. When you start to hedge our bets, you can go the other way. They're not very fast. I can stop them easy enough. What does this do for me? I have to push them up so I have a free piece. Alright, the one die is bound to be more successful on here. It's still got tackle on me, so it's still 3+ to get out of there, but I guess this has the most upside, right? Even though I could get tackle off, he's still penned in, so. More chances of the knockdown, more upside. Guess we're going with the runner. And no upside. Other than a one die surf, maybe? Or no. Two strength, right? Yeah, 2 days up hill. Oh, wait a minute. Is there any way to give him room? I don't think there is. All right, let's try though. You greedy mother. Damn it! How many of those have I rolled? 5 or 6 so far? He's rolled 1? That's fair. Definitely not 1 and 6 for me. It's more like 50-50. Maybe 60-40. Again, 67% to send him on his way. Nope. Of course, pal. Of course. Wow. Boxcars, holy shit. Wrecked. He rolled 1, 2, 3. He rolled 4 sixes on that sequence. Four sixes out of 6 dice. That's pretty good. Hard to fail with those numbers. Scatter's not terrible. Unless it does something like that. Although he can scatter again, can he? Oh! He has no rerolls, right? Oh, no, he does. Fuck. There you go. I guess those are the skulls I was complaining about not seeing. Alright, how do I get loose? Not easily, apparently. Alright, well, you've got to mark the runner. Can't have you going anywhere. Actually, this might. Yeah, that gives me the 2 die. Alright, so, please move. That's all I wanted. I just wanted him to move. Yeah, I have to follow. And then you can move the runner. Yep, that's all I wanted. Just move them. That's all I asked you to do. No greedy Gusses here. Ogre does absolutely nothing. You, on the other hand, are free. Oh, you go pick up this runner. And now we'll try and sprint for glory. If we can pick the ball up. Which is a big if, of course, because this is me playing Blood Bowl. So those are long odds. Long odds for simple plays. Alright, it's going around though, I guess. If it's going around, I guess I can't complain, can I? Well, I have to surf you. It's just, it's not really negotiable. So hopefully you go down. You did. Good job. Are these both blitzers? No, you're not a blitzer. Alright, let's put you on the ball. Let's pray for a push. That'll work. That's pretty good. So I don't mind getting terrible dice as long as my opponent does too. Can I get the thrower in there? Ooh, that'd be better. Ah, it's two GFIs. What do I have to move out of the way? Him? If the runner doesn't go down... Oh, even if he does go down, he just gets in the way, doesn't he? Yeah. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, yeah. I need to go like... 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. That's still a GFI. Okay, I guess the catcher's just gonna go for it. That's the case. Let's try and take out the other runner. Nope. So we got another mighty blow. Another block hit. Another push. Awesome. Alright, let's see if he can not roll a one this time. He is picking up the ball. Yes, yes. Well, attempting to. Alright. Pretty good. Who can get me? The runner. You know what? I think I just post the thrower up. Give him a little cover. Ogre does nothing. You do nothing. Alright. We made lemonade out of lemons. Look at that. You know, provided he can't do the same, I score. And I'm up a player. Potentially. We both have a KO, I guess. So makes the casual 4+. Gets a push, though. All right. We still hope so we can get a push. We score. Still could try and dodge at that runner. Yeah. No. Okay. Bloodlust. He was better off dodging at the runner though. Cover the front. Take away the assist. Oh, I do have two players down here. Okay. I guess I get there anyway. Oh, that assists. Yeah. But then I just run one of those two players, said players, up and cancel that. So. And that guy doesn't have tackle, so it should be okay. Famous last words in Blood Bowl, I know, but it should be okay. Yeah, those two guys, we're never going to do anything, so you can go ahead and hang out with them, make friends. I was going to say, he already had his casual 4+. He shouldn't be allowed to have another. I need you to stand here, sir. And I need you to push him, sir. That'll work.
That'll work. Shameless Soul runs it in.
Look at that face paint. That's pretty cool. Okay, so I do not have a numbers advantage. No, we're even. I do get one more opportunity, though, to get up. Do I just... Yeah, sack the lineman. Sack the lineman. This is your lot in life, guys. Just don't break. It's like I'm missing someone, yeah? Someone's knocked out. So. This is where I could lose the game, though. If he gets removals, and then he gets another shot at me next half. And yeah, I could find myself down three or four players pretty easy. Digging those new unis, though. And he gets a reroll to hit me harder. Damn. Hopefully he burns it on the first failed block. If the first block is the first block that fails, is the first block. If that makes any sense. Oh, he put a loner in position. Ooh, that's a big no-no. Be funny if the loner got an injury. Could have been someone useful. Oh, okay, oh, that's bad. What I just said, three or four removals. I could be in a lot of trouble between this turn and his next. At least he shouldn't be thinking foul anyway, so. Just pass it now, run the blitzer back. And pass it to him with the runner. If he fouls, then it's just wow. It's actually a bad trade-off even if he gets me. He's trading 70k for 50. If not more, but he should foul with a long beard, so. No. Your internal clock is incorrect today, Kitty. Is he going for it? He is. All right, ref. Do your job, please. He did his job. The ref did his job. I don't care about the death. Just as long as the ref does his job. All you can hope for. You can't control the armor break. Just hope the ref does his job. Alright, I need these guys back though. Ah, shit. Oh, we got one. Shit. Oh, we're even though. Okay. Guess the ogre's going on the line now. Which, sucks a little bit. But. Such is the spot I find myself in. So I have 369, he should have 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 as well. Alright. I know, Crispy, that's why I made you the ogre, see? You're the big shiny ogre. Oh, perfect D! Why, thank you. Oh, look where the ball is, though. Well, you haven't done much yet, but you haven't gone boneheaded yet either, so. Oh, the Troll Slayer. I'm an idiot. I should have put him away from the he should be on the other side. No! Kitty, it's not even 4 o'clock! You're going crazy, and we're nowhere near dinner time. This is my fault. I set up wrong. Now, if he could just push me once in a while, that'd be great. Now, she wants supper, but we're a long ways out from supper. Yeah. Oh, what a disaster. All because I put the ogre in the wrong spot. This is all my fault. Wow, he hit everything. This is disgusting. I definitely got punished for my mistake. A removal, a stun. Didn't shank the ball. It's gonna go to the right, obviously. There's nothing over there. My only question is, what are the balls like on this guy? Is he gonna go for the win? Oh, there's a push, finally, when it's irrelevant. Is he gonna go for the win? Or is he just gonna dwarf fucking tie? Oh my god. Of course. Well, I don't have much I can do for my turn except get hit again. So, that's fun. I'm just gonna get hit again. I'm gonna blitz with the ogre though. Since I'm screwed anyway, I might as well go for something. Hey, I got him! Ah, no armor break though. No, winning all 20 is never gonna happen, dude. Never gonna happen. What I needed was a lucky armor break. I didn't get it, but. Such is life. But at least I scored, so. Losing this game is gonna be hard to do. He hasn't done anything that makes me think he's this amazing dwarf coach or anything. He's been fairly confident, but other than that. And with one runner gone, and he nerfed his own bench with that foul, so. He traded 70 for 50, so that's a win for me. One less tackle out there too for my catchers to deal with, so. That's good. Although they're both chilling on the bench right now, so I guess they don't have to deal with any of the tackle right now. Oh, she's pouting now. She's got her back to me, staring at the wall. In the Sphinx pose. Yeah, do it. Do it. Oh, you're supposed to fail, though. You're not supposed to succeed. That's the worst part. I need him to score quickly. So I can try and win. Well, actually, neither one of us can win if he doesn't score quickly. So it's on him to decide if there's going to be a winner or not, basically. Ogre's 5 movement, right? I think so. I like that he threw that one die with the loner and didn't get punished. gets me wet. Yeah, ogres have 5. Okay, so I could blitz him and move backwards 1. Wow. 1 die OP. Doesn't matter if I have block. It just works. Alright, I've got to make some dodges this turn. So let's think about this. He's gone. I can make a dodge with him. Dodge him out. I can just move this guy, which I should do. And not follow on the off chance I actually break his armor. Let's stay out of the range of this Longbeard, eh? Let's go like here. You have to go first. You're closer, so I think we dodge you. Please work. I have to reroll these. Okay. Again, please work. Shit. Okay. Ogre next. Bonehead. Beautiful. So you can't go anywhere. I'm still going to have to try. I'm just going to fail, but at least he moves. At least he moves. I just got to apply pressure. But he shouldn't really feel any. He's up a dwarf. Although, I guess if you thin enough dwarfs, even if they're up numbers, it still hurts them, right? But with the fact he can just cage and I can't... Humans are so average, right? I can't cage dive. I can't really bust cages very well. Yeah, well, you can play... Winners play with teddy bears, Crispy. Winners play with teddy bears. Are you a winner? Not yet. So it looks like I'm going to get the hit. No, I'm not. He's going to cage up. What am I thinking? He's going to cage up. Sideline cage even. Six plus cage dive? With GFIs? It's doable, right? Shouldn't be that hard. That blitz are gonna... please? Please? Oh, no. He was only teasing me. What a dirty slot that is. Teasing me with that. Six plus double GFI, 2 dice uphill. Sounds easy, right? Actually, I can mark these guys, can't I? Yeah. Or I do it with him, and I don't need the GFIs. Yeah, I don't need the GFIs with him. Six plus for the win! Oh, the dodge is gonna fail, but it'd be funny. Alright, we're going for it. There was no losers on this team. What'd I get? Was it another 2? That was a 3. He did better, though. He went from a 2 to a 3. Fizzy, Just punched in the face for his trouble, for being the helper. Fizzy Zack, for those in the know. I think he's gonna stall. I think he's gonna be a bitch, but they're dwarves. Can't really blame them. I think this was about as fast as he could have scored, honestly, so he can score this turn. It leaves him four turns, which is not terrible for dwarves, but given the fact he's down a runner, he probably is incentivized to go for the draw, but it's just, it's a second game. I just hate it. Gotta go for wins early in your build. Can't stress that enough. Don't be a bitch. Don't go for ties. You're just slowing yourself down. There he goes. He's not a bitch. Look at that. He's going to play the odds. My KOs stay out. He's actually in good shape. Oh, I got a catcher, though. All right. We're at least even. So here's the options now. Do I just set up a Hail Mary play for turn 16? Or do I try and jam it down there sooner? I don't know. We'll see what the kickoff bench brings. We'll leave our options open. Nice weather, so nothing. Okay. Deep kick. Alright, looks like we're going for Hail Mary. Oh, gotta move him. Man, you're just gonna get on my last nerve today, aren't you, Cat? Oh, that sucked.
Something happened. Shawnee is one.
Oh, now hosting with one. Okay. Seems like, here come all the auto hosts. Okay. Well, I want my triple with the ogre. Where'd the ball go? It's over there. It's the only good thing about dwarves, you know, they're not going to rush you down, eh? Ogre's my best chance to remove one of these fucks. Guess the lineman heard me. Got a little salty. I have one reroll. I can straight up one die him? Okay. That's not terrible. No, we're not doing that. Alright, we gotta keep the catcher free though. Come back here. Alright. Ogre, do good work. That's good work. Just make sure. Had a lot of misclicks with the stick on this controller lately. Want to make sure my mighty blow gets the opportunity. I'll take a both. Well, I have block. Never mind. Of course I'll take a both down. 50-50. I actually got the right side of it. No break, though. And I didn't get the ball. Nice. I'm glad I left that to the end. Why did my blitzers go back? Well, I want them to worry about scoring threats, so. I don't want to say they're decoys, because obviously if they're back there, they could score, but. Obviously, I've got other inclinations in mind, but. I just don't think he's going to apply any ball pressure on me, so. Or at least nothing I can't get away from. Because right now, all of his long beards are tied up. He just tied up his only other tackle piece, so. He's just obsessed with this ogre. He shouldn't be, but he is. He's got three rerolls. He could one die the ogre fairly comfortably with a reroll. It's only 1 in 36 to not to fail, right? Or to fail. So he doesn't need Dauntless. Gets it anyway. Alright. Ogre still gets to tie up three people when he stands up, though. No! I don't know what you want, kitty. I can't help you. It's not dinner time. Maybe he thinks you're a troll. I don't know. He's a little confused. Trolls are taller and greener and leaner. Though I use the term leaner loosely, but I guess there's no reason to stall either, is there? If I can score, I should just score. It's only one? I thought it was going to be two. Alright, I need the ball. Start moving you. I am going to take this one die, I think. There's nothing there, right? No, that is open. Okay. I'm just thinking if I only get a push. Do I stay or follow? I think I stay. This guy's not going to catch anybody, so fuck him. I'm not worried about him at all. This would be a good one die as well. This should be my one die blitz, though. And then I can move him right in the sweet spot here, maybe. Yeah. If he goes down. He has to go down, though. Or, no. No, I don't. I move him here. I push him here and move him here. Yeah, that sounds right. If he goes down. If he doesn't, I guess I just push him and stay on him. I've only got the one. I don't need the reroll, though, as far as scoring with the catcher, though, so. Alright, so yeah, we'll try this first. Yeah, I only pushed him. I guess we just stay on him. Could have repositioned up one tick, but okay. He's completely out of range, just to double check. Yeah, okay. Alright, that's good stuff. And yeah, we stay. Now we get the ball. These balls are fun. Most of the time. Let's check his movement one more time. He can get to the line. Okay. Where can this guy get if he gets cheeky? Decides to just potato out. So he can get to the line, he can get to there. So right here is where I want to stand. And can this guy help anything? He could help a two die here. But not really, so I think dodging out here might be okay. I'm not rerolling, obviously, but if I could apply a little more pressure in the back, that's pretty good. Alright, he's got outs, but at least I made sure they weren't very good. I think the Troll Slayer is due for some kind of fail, too. Oh, he's just going to go for the low-hanging fruit. Look at that. Freeze up the long beard, makes the correct play. Now he can cover the catcher. Oh, yeah, no. Okay, that's actually not good. You should have continued to apply... If that's what the guy's role was, to apply pressure to the thrower, that's what he should do. So now there's no pressure on him to do anything. Probably throws this one... He's got three rerolls still. He's been rolling like a demon this half. Everything's working. Or just not failing, I guess. Maybe not working. Not failing is the same thing, I guess. Obviously, an ogre block would be amazing, but can't risk that. Yes, that's... Yeah, no, that's the one. If you're going to free up my blitzer, please. That's insane. Yeah. That just lets me free up my catcher. He can't do that. Can't do that. As it is, I think I'm going to... What do I do here? Yeah, I see pass plays too, Crispy. I see them. You can dodge him out. Blitz him off. I have the reroll. Obviously, I'm all in if I do that. I still have this deep scoring threat. Of course, then he could add an assist if this guy fucks up. Hmm. Yeah, there's nothing good in here. Only the ogre gets two dies, and of course that's risky as hell. If he boneheads, I'm fucked, so. This guy's still completely safe, right? Oh no, he could be touched now. But I can't move him until after I do what I do, so. Because then I can't throw, so, obviously. Alright, so we're going for this. And of course... As always, 1-9. No, I actually get to throw the block. Okay. And I did push him. Nice. And we'll push him straight back. And we'll stay. And we'll go cover the runner again. Now, it's big time play time. Reroll's built in. It's going to be 50-50, though. Hopefully, he can manage the 75%. He can on the first try, even. Catcher comes through. Mr. Potato, go, go, go. All right. You can't get there. All the pressure's on him now. You can't get there. You can't get there. Okay, now I could actually throw a block with the ogre. But what's a good block to throw with the ogre? Obviously, that would be amazing, but I can't take it. I gotta leave it up to him to fail. I don't have any rerolls, so I can't give him a free blitz. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Yeah, right now he needs a dodge and a GFI, so. Troll Slayer can't affect this either, so let's try and hit the Troll Slayer. And I think I just stay put. Another stun. Wow. Blitzer. Actually, hold on. I got a free piece. If I move the Blitzer, though. My free piece can move more. In fact, he can get all the way around. Yeah, grab this long beard. I don't need to stall, by the way, in case you were wondering. We're definitely short on time now. I just score if I get in next turn. I'm not worried about the dwarf one-turner, so... Okay, the dodge succeeded. That was my best hope for a fail here. Push, he re-rolls. And he gets me. Alright, I can recover, though. Obviously, the downside of that whole play is my blitzer's free. So. I can make cat noises too. It won't help you get fed any sooner. I don't know what's up with you today. and just refilled your bowl. If you're that hungry, go eat. One dies the ogre. Can't say I'm surprised. Could just go for the win and one die blitz that blitzer, but I think it's safer to two die blitz him. Well, I gotta see what happens the rest of the turn, I guess, but. Like, if he does this and throws that block and one and nines it, I guess I can play it safer. Like, I can't lose at this point, right? So. Yeah, that gives me a two die. That's what I would like to do. But it depends if he can add any more threats. Depends on how this block goes. If he one and nines it, I can do that. If he doesn't, maybe I just go for the win. Or he just loses his fucking mind. Just fucking runs for the ball. Oh, shit. Alright, now I'm fucked. Now I just have to hit the runner. Hope the scatter's good. And dodge out the fucking catcher to get it, wherever it ends up. Obviously, if that blitzer catches the scatter, then it's GG. Not much I can do then. Can I get on top for the angle? I can. Okay. Good luck to me. I got it loose anyway. That was not the best scatter, though. Okay. Ah, I don't have any movement left. Ah, shit. Alright, let's see if I can dodge and pick up. I cannot dodge. One and nines are too difficult for me. They're too hard. So it's probably GG. There's still an opportunity, but I would have made the GFI, actually, so maybe I should have tried. It was still was a one next. Oh, what was the push is a three, so I would have made the first dodge. And then I would have scalded the pickup. So it still would have been a fail, regardless, I guess, if you believe in the fact that whatever comes up next is what was going to come up next. But that, to subscribe to that theory, is the entire game is already predetermined once it starts. And they're not a fresh reroll generated each and every time, so. He's got a two. I just take the two die blitz on the ball, dude. This is not complicated. You can't win, so just make sure I can't. As long as he doesn't want in 1296 this, he's how amazing would that have been? He should have scattered it too, by the way. Out of bounds. Just to be safer. I guess there's a small chance it bounces up and off the catcher and forward, but he's got movement to cover that anyway. If that happened, he could run around and cover it. So I think he's going to decide if he's trying to pick it up, maybe. I think he's better off, yeah, just being right where he is. I do have a play. The thrower obviously blitzes and pushes that blitzer, and the catcher again attempts to get up, grab the ball, and run to the end zone, but it's not fantastic, but it's what's there, so obviously I'm going to try it. Again, I just need a push, so it's 67% chance of success. Wow. Oh no, that's the blitzer. Okay. So now I need a dodge as well. So now it's 3 plus 67%. Yeah, it's kind of irrelevant. I wasn't going to add more rolls. The ogre could potentially free up a lineman, but does that actually do anything for me? 4, 5, no, it doesn't actually do anything for me. So my play is the same. Oh, I could just use the blitzer now since there's no difference. Or I could try one die to free him. But it's only 50-50 to actually free him, isn't it? Or no, it's still 67, but the downside's only 1 in 6. But there's also a 1 in 6 that nothing happens. But what's... I guess if I dodge and I get the bolt down, then at least the catcher could try some stupid fucking play. As opposed to just being over. Any math wizards in the chat could tell me what the percentages are. What's the better percentage play? Is it better to take this one die if he goes down and then take this one die to push him? Or is it better to just dodge and try the one die with the blitzer? Wow, that's a complicated problem. It's a 3 plus to dodge, so it's 67% to dodge, and then 67% to move the blitzer. Or it's 67%... No, he has to go down, right? So it's only 33% for him to go down. Because if he doesn't go down, then I still need to do another... Yeah. It's not the same, Crispy, but... There's a difference, I just don't know what the difference is. But I'll just fail this and it just won't matter. So, okay. A little excitement for the chat. I actually got to this point. It doesn't matter if I follow or not, doesn't matter. Another stun, so I didn't injure any dwarves. Oh no, I injured the runner. Right. Can he pick up the ball? It looks like he can. And can he make a GFI? He can! We win. Wyatt does it. Good job, buddy. Okay. So it looks like when it matters, the humans perform. Both halves, it was like last second touchdowns. Okay. So we get a win. For game number one. In our new unis. I bought those, by the way, if you're wondering. 20 scions I spent. For those beautiful yellow jerseys. Oh, and a big six. So we can get an... Who was the MVP? It was the thrower. We got a level, too. Wow. 10 armor breaks to 9. We broke dwarves more than dwarves broke us, and on less blocks. Ooh. But he had more removals. Oh, I got a dead player to replace. Yeah, okay. So I guess I'm not buying an apple. Unless the thrower gets, like, something really cool. And it's worth protecting him. Well. The thrower just got something pretty cool. Alright, any human coaches in the chat? Is it dodge? Or is it strong arm? What do we go? What is the choice? Those are the options. Dodge or strong arm. Let me know in chat. I'm going to go buy the new lineman. Or no, I'm going to buy the Apo. We're going to run a loner. Obviously, the thrower is worth saving now, so... Crispy says dodge. Anybody else? Any of the lurkers want to chime in with their opinion? I don't know what I'm going to take, honestly. I don't know what's better, dodge or strong arm. How does it... This guy's not running the one turn. The runner... The catchers would be doing the one turn. How does this... No, strong arm would make the one turn easier. Because then it'd be a better chance to throw it wherever he gets it from. If that's your logic. Dodge, this is the thrower, not a... The catchers come with dodge. For a catcher for a one turn on doubles, I guess they'd have passing and strength. I don't know if anything helps the catcher. Nerves of steel, maybe. He could stand in a tackle zone and catch it. Yeah, I'm thinking strong arm, too. It's nice to have more dodge, though. It's always good to have dodge early. Because you don't see a lot of tackle early, except for dwarves, of course. But we'll try and turn him into a mighty, mighty thrower, I guess. So, boom. Busy Zach. Yeah. Now you... Thanks, Talkie. Now you chime in after I've already made my decision. But oh well. We got a win. That's going to do it for the first game in 20 games with humans. I am Duron. We'll be back tomorrow. Thanks for watching.